You know, I was thinking about a new tutorial idea, and then it got into my mind that when I first started to do 3D and doing just tutorials, I remember that in some time I just saw a tutorial about doing some kind of a softbox, not just a normal light, but a better way to light the scenes. And I was like, okay, maybe I should do it also. So, hello guys, today we are gonna do a tutorial about this kind of a softbox where the light source is inside of an box. Let me just search it up. So that's what we are talking about. This kind of an object which it's diffusing the light, and it's also getting some details to the kind of a light, like if we are looking here. But that's the exaggerated version. We have also one which is like a white light. So as we can see here on the edges, there is not as much light. It's not so white like in the center, and that's what's happening with the softbox. Like the light source, it's going through that translucent material, and is not even in all of the places. So let's create a new file just in general. Okay, we don't need anything from here. I'm just gonna start, let's say, with a circle. 5 sides for the circle, filling with a triangle fan. That's just gonna be simple like that. Let's go into shading, as that's where we need to play around. I'm gonna get the settings to cycles easier. Okay, we can already hit render, but there's gonna be nothing. Let's get the material. I'm gonna name it light, just like that. Now I'm gonna delete the principal BSDF, as is not helpful for us with just the light. It's too much. We can do it from a principal BSDF, but we have a simpler node here, like emission, just like that. Now what I'm gonna do with that, as we can see, we are having even lighting from it, which is good in some ways, but we wanna add some more details to it. So I'm gonna go to textures, and I'm gonna bring a gradient texture. Plug the factor. I'm gonna switch from linear to spherical, just like that. Now it's not perfectly in center. I'm gonna press Ctrl T with a node wrangler, or I can bring it from here, like texture coordinate, it's here. And for the mapping, I can go to vector, and that's it. Now I'm gonna switch from generated to object, and this should bring it right in the center as I want it. So I can use this material for any shape. Like, let's bring a plane, which is gonna be just four-sided. I'm gonna put it here. Let's take the light. As we can see, it's right in the center, but we are gonna stick with this kind of a circle here. I'm gonna move the nodes a little bit further away from the emission node. Then I'm gonna go to converter, color ramp, and that's gonna bring a color ramp. What I wanna do, I wanna play a little bit with the handles here. I'm just gonna put a handle right here. Now we can see that these edges are too black, which needs not wanted. Like, we don't want a perfect black. We just want a small change in it. Like, let's say gray, it's fine. Maybe we can adjust also this white here, just like that. And that's just perfect. Now, that's the case with a white light. Let's say you want to change the color, and it's not so straightforward just to make the color like that, and you have to go also here. You have also to adjust this here. No, it's too much. If you wanna do a lot of colors, that's just wasting time. So what I am gonna do, I'm gonna bring a mix RGB node. I'm gonna plug it in here, just like that. And by switching it to color, let's make the factor to 1, just like that. Now if I change the color to it, as you can see, everything is just matching. And that's fine if you wanna go for an artificial color, like the artificial color are the ones that you are not seeing in nature, like for the sun, which it's green, red, purple, blue, something like that. So we are gonna go and take a black body node, and I'm gonna plug it into color 2. Let's get a 4500 value for it, just like that. So that's yellowish. What I mean about artificial colors and natural colors, I'm just gonna show here. So the values that we are having into the black body, let me get it bigger. As we can see, we have a temperature value. And what this is describing, it's this kind of a value, like here are the values for the color temperature. These are all the colors that we can see naturally. Like as we gone for 4500, we are somewhere around here. If we go for 6000, 7000, we are getting this kind of a blue. We have more for this. So that's like the value here. Let's go to 7000. As you can see, we just moved to a blue color. But for the moment, I'm gonna 4500, or maybe let's go to 5500. So it's almost white, just like that. So that's perfectly fine. That's like the kind of light that we are looking for. Now that's like all we need. Maybe I'm gonna add a small detail to it. I'm gonna duplicate the thing here, and I'm gonna do also that kind of the box that a softbox light it's having, just like that. Let's get a new material. It's gonna be a simple one. Let's make it black, just like that, and that's fine. Now I'm gonna bring an empty X, just like that. I'm gonna select everything, Control P, set parent to the object. So why I've done that, let me just move a little bit the thing. Now I can select only the empty. Let's name the empty also light, just like that. I'm gonna bring another empty. This time it's gonna be a cube. Let's make it just like that. I'm gonna select this empty here. I'm gonna move it a little bit on the y-axis, just like that. So what I'm gonna do with it, it's I'm gonna go to constraints, and let's put a track to. The target is gonna be the cube empty that we just created. Now we have to change a little bit the tracking axis, like it was on minus Z and that was pointing in the wrong direction. But now that's following it. So if we are moving the light, as you can see, it's following that empty. So that's better. Like if I'm just duplicating it. So now the light is following the cube, the empty cube. I can duplicate it one more time. Let's just move for once more. Maybe I will scale it just like that. Now I'm just playing with a little bit, just like that. So we have the empty. Let's set it as a, that's gonna be easier for us to follow. So we have light one, light 001, light 002, just like that. And let's see how everything it's looking. I'm gonna bring a plane. I'm gonna scale a little bit the plane, and let's bring something to reflect those lights on. I'm just gonna subdivide the Suzanne, just like that. Shade smooth. Let's make a fast material, like roughness to 0. I'm gonna get, let's say, a green color, maybe a little bit darker, just like that. And let's look at the render. So that's how it's looking. Now we can go for the lights and maybe put some more strength into the emission, just like that. So we can see in the reflection those details for the gradient map. Now, let's say we want to change the colors. We can go right here. We don't really need to go for the shading tab. We can just adjust the things here. So let's go for 3000. That's gonna be a yellowish color, just like that. But as we can see, the colors are changing for every single light. And let's say we wanna have different temperatures for lights. So we can just hit this button, which is gonna make a new material from the existing one. So this material now for this object, it's separated from those two. So for this one, let's try 8000. So that's gonna be really blue color. And just like that, we got two tones of a color for the softbox. And as we can see, that's getting us that kind of a soft shadow. Let's make it also, let's make the material rough, like 0.5, just like that. So it's getting us just a soft shadow. It's using studio, like it's not getting us the harsh shadows. But of course, you can also make it, you can also make the shadows harder on them. Like the shadow, it's ruled by the size of the light. So if I'm changing the size of this light, now it's not as powerful as before. But if I change the strength, like let's say we are going for 6000, that's gonna get us much more. Let's make it a little bit bigger, just like that. So as you can see, the shadow is harder. Maybe the strength is too much, just like that. And something else that we can also make with those soft boxes, as let me just get it this bigger. What we can make also with the soft boxes, I'm gonna select this empty here. Let me get the cursor here. I'm gonna change this light. Let's delete that panel. I'm gonna get a normal light. That's gonna be a point light, just like that. Let's move a little bit on y-axis, just like that. That's gonna be also parented to this. Control P object, just like that. Let's get a bigger strength. Now for this material, I'm gonna change a little bit the things, like as it's gonna be all the way white, metallic, roughness just smaller, just like that. So now we have another kind of light box, which is having this kind of a reflective material all around, and the light source is visible, and that's getting us some more reflective details. Let's make this one back. So here we can see the reflection of that. And now, like, let's say you want to use it in more scenes. Let's just get out of render. I'm gonna save. That's gonna be lights, just like that. I'm gonna save the object, and then let's see, light on, it's here. Just like that. So we have with everything saved. Now, if we want to go to another scene, we don't really have to create everything from the scratch, like losing time just to take everything from here. It's too much. So let's just say that I'm getting rid of this light. That's gonna be the new scene that I'm working on, a new project. And I do not want to stay again and do all the materials and all of that. I've just done it once. Now I can go to append. Let's take back the file, the lights that blend, and we can go to objects. And here in the objects, we can just select like light. There's gonna be circle and empty as a target. So that's all we need. We can also name them better and append. I forgot to take the softbox, but it's fine. And now if I render, it's also having the material. It's also having the constraint. I can just go to cycles, let's render with the GPU, just like that. And after you've done it once, you have it to use it as you want. You can scale it, you can add more, you can then separate the light and give it another value, and the problem is solved. Let me get the camera bigger. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial and you found anything helpful, anything new in it. Please leave me a like, subscribe, and comment if you have any questions. And maybe you can join my Discord server and show me what you used the lights on. That was it. See you into the next one. Bye.